What inspired me to study at UCL was definitely the variety of courses offered. So when I was transitioning from a biochemistry background into the pharmaceutical industry, I was looking for something quite specific, and UCL actually had 3 or 4 different options that I could pick from. So definitely the variety of courses, as well as when I started doing my research, I saw that UCL was a global university, consistently in the top 10, and therefore they have a pristine reputation, which I wanted to be part of. So what drew me to studying my course was, as I mentioned, the specificity of the course. So I wanted it to sort of reflect what I wanted to do in the future, so the drug development pathway, but especially the business acumen side. So the pharma management component was something I hadn't seen elsewhere, and it's definitely something that I use now in my day-to-day work life. I enjoyed studying in London very much, so much so that I now currently live here after 4 years of studying. I enjoyed the variety of things that you could do. So no matter what your hobbies are or what you're interested in, London has that to offer you. So that's definitely something that I found. And also the location of UCL's campus, right in the heart of London in Bloomsbury, was something that I really enjoyed when I was studying in London. So my favorite memory of studying at UCL, I would have to say, it's hard to pick between all of the memories, but I'd say from a personal side is I met my partner here at UCL. We'd go, you know, weekly student bars and had lots of great fun meeting new people. And from the course perspective, I'd say it was the presentations that I did with colleagues, so building the slide deck and then presenting and sharing our findings to our fellow colleagues in the pharma management component, especially with Dr. Phil Holt. So yeah, I'd say that was my favorite memory. The advice I'd give to new students would be to fully engage and sort of have the courage to just dive in, meet new people, try new things, and also pick courses based on what you enjoy and not necessarily what you want to get out of it. So I think that's definitely the main two things I would recommend. I'm currently employed at a clinical research organization, so companies that do clinical trials, and my company name is Parexel. I work in the pricing and market access function of that. So which is when a therapeutic is reimbursed, when a therapeutic is approved, it needs to be reimbursed on a national level. So here in England, it would be reimbursed by the NHS. And I work in those submissions with pharmaceutical clients. So my core duties now are content development for all of my projects when we submit for reimbursement of clients' therapeutics. And I'd say the skills that I utilize the most are presentation skills, firstly. So not only when presenting and asking questions to clients, but also when providing status updates to my colleagues, and communication skills comes as a part of that. And definitely also the knowledge component, which is something which I managed to take from my course at UCL. So yeah, definitely the knowledge component and communication skills. So when I was studying at UCL, I had the opportunity to undertake an internship at a boutique consulting firm called Life Science Dynamics. And I did that in conjunction with my dissertation. And I'd like to say that that was sort of my first step into my career that I have today. And since then, I graduated, I submitted my thesis, and I was lucky enough to start work nearly straight away in September 2023 at Parexel. UCL provided me with the opportunity to conduct an internship, which were my first steps in my career today. So they provided me with a platform to get the job. Not only that, they provided me with great skills, so communication skills and the knowledge component of my job currently. And I've also met fantastic people at UCL, fantastic lecturers, fantastic colleagues, which I'm still in contact with today. So yeah, all of those things UCL gave me.